up, everybody? Nash Tyler Harrington with CONtv, hanging out here at San Diego Comic-Con. And standing right next to me is Sal with the Alex Ross Gallery. It's a gallery this year. It's quite the setup. Can you tell us what went into this change that you guys brought this year?
We wanted to, this is our 17th year, we wanted to approach it a little differently. Comic-Con is great, but as you can it's just become a little visually chaotic. Yeah. So I just wanted to, we wanted to let the fans, especially Alex's fans, focus more on the art and less on the logos and things like that. So we tried a little cleaner at more of an Apple Store kind of aesthetic. Yeah. So that, again, they could focus more on Alex's work and less on the logos.
Can you tell us, you mentioned the last 17 years, I feel like the convention has changed exponentially in that amount of time. What has kind of changed, other than the booth design, what's kind of changed for Alex as well as, in these 17 years?
We came and it started as we were here representing Alex as a comic artist, and it's different now where we just wanted to be Alex see more just as an artist. And again, Alex wants to try to get his work out to more than just the comic book fan base, which is our core, obviously, what we know and love, but we wanted to showcase more of the other things that we want to do, too.
And I think one of the really cool things is that behind us, and we'll get some shots of it so everybody can see the detail, but you guys have, Alex has gotten the rights to develop the artwork around a lot of really, really awesome properties, one of which being the Beatles. Can you tell us a little bit about that process and what he plans to do with
it? He's a huge fan, as we all are, growing up with the Beatles. We're comic guys, but still, Beatles are part of a phenomenon. And we approached to do Yellow Submarine, which was the animated feature, and we wanted to do their take. Alex wanted to do his take. We were approached by Apple and our buddy Joe, Marziato, and we started to talk about it, possibility. Alex was ecstatic over it, and then it just kind of fleshed itself out into a portrait set of the Beatles themselves.
Yeah.
And you can't do them individually, you got to do them all together, so it's the Fab Four.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, going back to comics, because obviously that is a foundation for Alex, you've developed the Shadows series, and right now it's some of the DC characters. I know he's working on Marvel as well, but can you tell us a little bit about the backstory of the Shadows series?
The Shadows line was right now it's with Warner Brothers. We signed a deal with Warner Brothers. We're very excited about, and I just Alex wanted to just try different compositions, a different approach to it, where you and I will. Having a piece of art on your wall and then also having a piece of art on your wall that your wife lets you hang in the house or in your office at work, Alex wanted to just try a different approach to it. So he went with a little moodier, a little darker, a little more of a contemplative type of effect on each character.
And I know that taking a close look at those Shadows prints, they are prints, but we heard that the process that you guys used to create those, you can even see the brushstroke. Can you tell us a little bit about the level of quality?
Yeah, Alex is fanatic with how they come out, the colors and the exact, not just, it has to be the production of it is crucial, because the originals will look tremendous, and sometimes in production, there's a little bit of a tail off color-wise and effect-wise. So Alex is, he's very strict about how the finished product looks. And the good thing about the giclée process, which is it's almost like a canvas, is that the colors pop a lot more, and it allows you to kind of really get a feel of the actual painting versus just a kind of a flatter print.
Yeah, and a lot of times at Comic-Con you will see it's prints on poster paper and stuff like that. So to have something that's this high level of quality is really nice to see.
You want to try different things. You want to try different price points, obviously, to make them available at different sizes and different markets and things like that. Because some of the printing processes and some of the final products can get a little expensive, so you got to kind of play the ball at different levels, different price points.
Absolutely. Now let's talk about a couple of the other properties that are not necessarily fully displayed yet, because they're still in the process of being created. The one that I'm most excited about is the Universal Monsters. Well, can you tell us more about that?
Again, Alex and I, huge fans, all the way back to Creature Features when we were kids, the Universal Monsters, the black and white stuff we grew up with, Lugosi and Karloff and Lon Chaney. And it was just kind of a labor of love where we talked about it for a lot of years, and he was always kind of on Alex's bucket list of something he really wanted to do. And I said, look, why don't we try it? We fleshed it out a little bit. We spoke with Universal. We were very fortunate to be able to lock it down and get the licensing right. So it's something that we're excited about. It's coming out in the fall.
In the fall, okay. And is it a
time.
Okay. Yeah. Perfect. Is it along the lines of the Shadow series style artwork, or is it more of black and white?
Black and white. We're going to try it. We might do a silver screen edition where Alex tints it with a little bit of color, just kind of a subtle effect. But I think we're going to start with the black and white, you know, homage to the films and everything that way.
Perfect. All right. Well, I'm going to go start selling off a lot of my property so I can buy every single piece of artwork that's in here and put it up in the house.
Okay. It's here. So whatever you need.
All right. Well, thank you so much for spending time with us today, telling us a little bit more about what Alex has been doing. And is there a place where fans can, you know, if they didn't have the opportunity to be here at Comic-Con, that they can access this art online or?
Finer Art Galleries. It's going to, you know, all be available in Finer Art Galleries, the Beatles, the Warner stuff. The Marvel stuff and the Universal stuff also at alexrossart.com.